It was September 1998, and I found myself in Siberia, Russia. I had gone teaching. The most intelligent, talented children I've ever taught in my life. And after about 2 or 3 weeks, I'd noticed there was no meat on the plates. There was carrots, this, and there was cabbage, this. So I asked someone one day, you know, do you not eat meat? And says, yeah. And where do you get it? The market on a Wednesday. So I waited till the Wednesday. I remember putting my jacket on and gloves because it was like minus 23, minus 24. Walked down the street, followed the crowd, walking with their plastic bags. And there was just people tramping about in these sort of velvet boots. My market was like the old market you would see in Uri or something. It was just these stalls set up, vans open. There was no smell because it was so cold. There was no food being cooked or anything. It was just, there was the hustle and bustle. It was like, this was a special day for the people in the town I was in. Like, you have to remember, this is Siberia. What, 25, 30,000 people, so the market was a special occasion. There was Chechens, there was Ukrainians, there was people from Mongolia, and everybody was dressed in their own typical attire, but it was all big fur coats and boots and gloves, and I mean, it was music blasting. I didn't understand, like, it was a Russian. I walked over to the far corner, you know, round the corner, and there it was, a cow. A whole cow, tail, hoofs, hide, everything, eyes, hanging on a chain, dead, strung up. And there was a guy sitting there beside it. He had a big knife, a sharpening pole, whatever you want to call it. I mean, this was freezing cold, and this guy was just sitting there. And the next thing, this guy walked over and said, a 2 kilo. This little guy stood up, started sharpening his knife, just stuck it into the cow. And I mean, he cut out a square chunk of hide, bristle, blood, veins. It was just like, imagine taking a cold lasagna out of the fridge. It was just a block. I mean, I was waiting for the blood to drop. There was nothing drop. It was a frozen cow, but he cut a chunk, weighed it, put it into a plastic bag. And that guy walked off happily with his kilo of meat. I think it was the shock of it, because like, when you're here at home, everything's pre-packed. You go to a butcher, it's nice, cleanly cut. This was like the crude reality. I went home that night, and I used to have a housekeeper, and she used to come in and cook for me. And she made carrot soup as usual, and the carrot and garlic, I don't know what it was, but it was nice. And I just looked at her and I smiled and I said, thank God I never get meat again.